I am Matheus from Temple Support Team, and welcome to this quick guide on how to migrate your Jira and Temple Timesheets data from the server to the cloud. In this video, we are going to cover the migration using the JCMA application. If you are looking for information on how to migrate your Jira using the Jira Site Import method, you can check the other video in the description where we covered the subject. These are going to be the topics we're going to talk about in this video. Jira Site Import method in the JCMA, how the JCMA makes Temple migration easier, how to get prepared to migrate Temple using the JCMA, how to migrate Temple using the JCMA, possible problems might encounter, and how to reach out to us if you need any help. Let's get started by talking about the differences between the Jira Site Import method and the JCMA. The Jira Site Import method is the native site backup and restore function to move your data from the server to the cloud. Using this method, Temple's worklogs will be migrated, but all of Temple's structures such as accounts, themes, timesheets, holidays, and more will need to be migrated manually through CSV's import and REST APIs. It's also important to mention that the Jira Site Import method isn't available anymore for instances with less than 1,000 users. The JCMA, on the other hand, is a free add-on built and maintained by Atlassian that makes the process of migrating from server to the cloud much more easier. It's a project-based method that allows you to select with more flexibility which projects and add-ons you want to be migrated to the cloud. Using this method, Temple's worklogs and its own structure will be migrated automatically, so you don't need to make it manually. In order to use the JCMA, it's important to understand how the JCMA makes Temple's migration easier. By accessing the page Assets or Apps inside the JCMA configuration, you can select which add-ons you want to have migrated. Regardless if you select Temple to be migrated in the JCMA, the worklogs will be migrated by Jira. This part of the migration is managed by Atlassian, since Temple shares the same table with Jira to store the worklogs in the server. Once Temple is selected to be needed in the cloud, all of Temple's structure will be migrated as well. While your migration is running, you will see a progress bar where you can check the status of your Temple migration. Our side of the process is divided into tasks. Each task has a responsibility to migrate a specific part of Temple's structure. As the tasks finish, you can follow the progress until it hits 100%. Now we are ready to learn how to get prepared to migrate Temple using the JCMA. Recommend you to read our server to cloud documentation and the Atlassian pre-migration checklist before continuing. Both documents can be accessed in the video description. Some of the precautions described there are important to guarantee a successful migration, such as check the time zone of the server and the cloud instance before migrating. They need to be the same, otherwise the worklogs are going to shift one day back. Check if you are using Temple's latest version. Test your migration in a control environment before doing it in a production instance. Now comes the question, how do you migrate using Temple in the JCMA? We're going to show you how to do it in this quick time lapse. We selected two projects to be migrated as an example. Inside them, a few worklogs and one work attribute. In addition to that, four teams, two accounts, and some of Temple's default configuration. To start the migration, we need to access the page Migrate to the Cloud inside your system configuration. Then, we can create a new migration and connect to the cloud instance that we want to migrate to. Here, we are going to skip the advanced roadmaps plans, select the projects that we want to be migrated, and also configure the user and groups. The last step on this page is select the apps that you want to be migrated as well. In the page accessor apps, you can choose the ones that are important for you. If you don't have any errors and everything is looking good, you can move forward by clicking on Review Migration and then Run. Now your migration is started and it might take a while until it's finished. Now our migration is finished, and we can click on Go to the Cloud site to check if the data was correctly migrated. If you face any problems at this point, we are going to talk a little bit more about this in the end of this video. By creating a report, we can confirm if the work logs were migrated correctly. Switching to the correct time range, we can see that the work logs are here, as well as the teams, the accounts, and tempo's default configuration. Now that we have made a test migration together, I'd like to explain possible problems that you might face and how to proceed. First one is if your migration gets stuck. Each server instance is different and has its own particularities. If you see that the progress bar of your migration isn't changing after a few hours, this could mean that some of your migration tasks didn't run and got stuck. Although the migration is going to keep spinning your side, technically stopped. If you're running a migration test, you can get in touch with us and you can investigate the root cause of the problem. Then you can fix it before the production migration. If you're doing a production migration, we can help you identify which migration tasks didn't run and how to manually insert the missing data. Another possible issue is that your work logs are not appearing on the cloud side. Once the migration is finished, Temple will start syncing the work logs that were migrated by Jira to its own cloud database. The sync runs based on a listener that Atlassian provides. We receive the information that the work logs were created or migrated, and we sync that up. This process can take some time, according to the size of your instance, and can be triggered manually by our support team in case it fails. Last one, the work attributes that do not appear on the cloud side. The work attributes are always related to the work logs. To finish the process of migrating the work attributes, it's necessary to get in touch with Temple support. We will confirm that all work logs are synced to our database and then run the final step of work attribute migration. If you have any questions that weren't addressed in this video, please raise a request in your support portal. The link is available in the video description. There are a few important pieces of information you can share with us to speed up the troubleshooting process of a migration that didn't work as expected. The URL of the cloud instance you are migrating to, and a Support.zip file from your server instance. This is the current status of the migration process in June 2022. These steps might change without further notice. Please get in touch with us if you need any help. Thanks for your time and see you.